Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Singaporean Talks Money. Do remember to like and subscribe to my channel for me to produce more videos for you guys. So once again, a disclaimer that everything that is said in this video are my opinions and feedback. And you should always do your own due diligence before doing anything which involves your money and investing. So this week's topic is, how will I be able to achieve 100,000 by age 30? As you would know from previous videos, I'm currently 25 years old, and currently my plan is to achieve 100,000 by age 30. So how do I plan to reach that? Definitely it will be through a combination of investments, savings, and one endowment savings plan that I've bought when I was age 21. So why do I want to get 100,000 by age 30? So if I'm able to achieve that, it will provide me with a better peace of mind and stability to pursue what I really want. And definitely, I've heard this many times, where the first 100,000 will be tough to get, but after you reach that, the next 100,000 will come much easier because of the compounding effects, and you have a higher capital. And this has been proven by a lot of people who have managed to increase their net worth. So do also refer to my previous video on why you should start investing now. So on to my current progress. In my previous video, I talked about my current portfolio, which was 18,000. Definitely right now it is worth a bit more because I do have a monthly regular savings plan where I buy into indexes monthly. So in terms of savings, I have about 13,000 right now, and to add them all up, I have about $30,000. I mentioned earlier that my path to my first 100,000 will be through my savings, investment, and one savings plan that I have. So currently, I will break it all down for you guys. So I'm 25 years old this year, and since we are already more than halfway through 2020, so I'll be calculating based on the next 4 years, which means I'm starting from 26, 27, 28, 29. So for my savings, I'm currently putting aside about $400 per month. So our bank interest rate currently, let's just say it's 0.05%. So in terms of the table that I have put here, at a value of yearly deposits of $3,600, I would end up with a final amount of $27,440. I do have one savings plan which will mature when I'm 31 years old. I know that it's 1 year after 30, but I mean, I would just calculate in as part of the plan. So it will mature when I'm 31 in 2026, as I purchased it in 2016. So it is under NTUC called RevoSecure, where I will pay for 5 years, but the savings plan will be locked in for 10 years. So by the end of the 5th year, which is next year, I will not need to pay any more premiums, but the amount will be left there for until another 5 years, then I can cash it out. So there will be $18,449. And by the 10th year, when I'm 31 years old, it would have a value of between $21,720 to about $23,500, depending on the projected returns. So for investments currently, I'm now contributing about $700 per month to the ETF regular savings plan. So I've decided to drop the Tracker Fund of Hong Kong and switch to buying S&P 500 and Vanguard Total World Stock ETF monthly. So with an expected return of 6%, I am estimating that I would get about $63,000 after 4 years with compounded interest. So meaning there will be a yearly deposits of $8,400, And definitely the interest will increase per year because the amount would be higher. So definitely overall, of course, there is no guarantee the amount, as things can happen over the next 4 years, resulting in change of plan, for example, COVID-19. So some obstacle or things that can happen is, firstly, my investments might not be guaranteed to grow by 6% or even be positive at the end of 4 years. Definitely no one knows the stock market. And 4 years do seem like a pretty short time horizon. And judging by the uncertainty, we cannot really be sure that my investments will be profitable and get me the desired amount based on the table that is seen. So currently the US stocks are trading at an all-time high, and everyone is very confused by that, judging by current environment and the situation that the world is in. So fingers crossed that our investments hopefully will be good, and we shall see it soon. So secondly, during these 4 years, there might also be big ticket items on unexpected situations that might require me to use my money. So for example, maybe an accident could happen where I need to pay upfront cash, or yeah, that can affect my savings rate. Or maybe travel trips that I might spend beyond my means. Thirdly, what can affect them is my job stability and income. So judging by my job and job market currently, I can easily be jobless by the end of this year. Though I'm currently trying hard to find a job, I know that the environment right now isn't too positive, especially for entry levels. So as my contract job ends this year, and it's still unknown if I will have a job to fund my investments. And if I am out of the job, I might have to utilize my savings. Definitely, this all serves as a guide for me, and I hope to definitely achieve it if possible. But just would like to share with you guys and update my progress throughout the journey. Hope you guys enjoyed the video, and do journey with me on my personal finance. And do remember to like and subscribe. Thank you.